Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Continuing on here, the Corona acoustic guitar build. I'm gonna work on right now trimming up the back and the top. Flush cutting bit, router bit like this. And it's not gonna take all that long to do. Couple things to be cognizant of when you're doing it is, in order to avoid tear out, you want to run the router from the middle bout, the waist along the lower bout, and stop here, and then come from the top to the middle. If you go the other way, the router bit turning in a clockwise fashion will want to tear out your top or back, or the grain will just rip right out. So you want to go from the bout to the waist and take your time, not take off too much. Before we get started though, I do want to show you this little jig that I built. And remove this. So in a later video, or later on in this video, we'll see. I've been working on a binding cutting jig that will work in conjunction with this, and it's just a holder for the guitar. I am going to use it though for this process because it does hold it pretty well. But these little like feet here or jaws, they are adjustable, and you can just tighten up these screws. I used a 1/4 inch by 20 nutserts into the board and a couple screws, and then these pads here are adjustable up and down, the thought being you can get the guitar level. And like I said, once I show you the jig that I'm putting together and how this works in conjunction with that, it'll make a little more sense. A couple things I probably would have done different is I used a 3/8 router bit to route these channels here, and they're just a little too big for the hardware. And washers don't seem to work all that well, so I used these little thin piece of plywood and made little washers out of them. And I'm gonna probably change out this hardware to something with a wing nut or some sort of thumb screw, because I have to get in here with like a small right angle screwdriver to tighten these up, which is kind of a pain, but not the end of the world. But let me show you how it works. Even though this jig is sort of designed to work with that binding jig that I'm making up, the way it clamps in, it basically clamps onto the side of the guitar with this lip overhanging here. It doesn't get the greatest clamping surface, although it does clamp. But essentially, you just adjust your jaws here. Sides, okay. And you can move these pads up and down to level out the guitar. Do that here as well. Once the pads are at the right height, which they all seem to be, I can just take this little tool and tighten up the hardware down below. So, holds it well enough for me to do this routing. So let me get the router set up and we'll get this trimmed off.
Thank you. Thank you.
Get a piece that chipped out, which I was really afraid was going to happen. And the cedar top, man, is it, you know, I don't know what the word is, splintery? I don't know, it's terrible, but I'm not too concerned because, yeah, I'm going to be able to glue that. And the binding will. When I put the binding on it, it should blend right in. You shouldn't even see it. So let me do that real quick. Pieces of tape. And I'll just use the block plane to shave that off. So we'll let that dry and then we'll start working on the binding.
Alright, so this has had plenty of time to dry. So let's see what the repair looks like. I'm gonna try to trim this by hand instead of using the router. Not so bad, that'll blend in. So I'm just gonna tape my block plane. Tape my block plane here. Sandpaper. All say that turned out pretty well. Get you close up here.
So we are going to be working on the binding, cutting the binding slot, top and the bottom of the guitar. So I did show you this tray that I made on a previous or earlier in this episode. Essentially, it's a bunch of sort of like handles here, so you know, feet that grip the guitar itself, and they're adjustable in and out, and they have little pieces of wood here that support the work, and I can raise that up and down, and I've got it adjusted. These move in and out as well as up and down, and I've got it adjusted so that I have a uniform height all the way around. Okay, and I've got it tight, and it's pretty tight here, and it's not moving. I've also taken the time to wax the table saw top here, this cast iron top, so that this slides around real smoothly. And this device, probably seen a lot of these binding jigs online, and you know, you could spend hundreds of dollars for them, and you know, they look so simple, I figured why not try to make it or make one. And essentially I just created a large base. It's about 18 inches tall, and used a couple of ball bearing drawer slides or glides, whatever you want to call them, rails, and created this little router base that rides up and down on those rails. And this router base is 90 degrees from this base here, this vertical base. And essentially, I rest it down on the guitar, and it stays, keeps the router 90 degrees to the guitar side, whereas the top, you know, is slightly arched. And if you just had the router sitting on the soundboard or the back, it would be off kilter a little bit. So, you know, it's got a router bit in there that is a rabbiting bit and with a ball bearing, and I've done a couple test cuts for a binding, a standard binding size, and seems to fit in there pretty well. When it's all said and done, should be a little bit proud of the top and a little bit proud of the side, which is good. And kind of nervous, but we're gonna give this a shot and see how it turns out. So let me adjust the camera a little bit, give you guys a better angle. Thank you.
came out lovely. You know, after I made my initial passes and then I met in the middle, in the waist, I then went, you saw me go just completely around and not worry so much about the ground. So it's really not much to remove at that point. I wasn't worried about tear out. But waxing the table really helps because this whole base slides effortlessly. Alright, so next we are going to cut some binding strips out of some walnut, and we are going to heat, steam, and bend them to the shape. Alright guys, so I have the guitar mounted here on the side of my bench, and now that I have all the binding channels routed, I want to start working on the, I guess we can call this the end wedge, or the end inlay. Basically what it does is it covers the seam here where the two halves of the body are joined. Now if you notice, let's see in the back, I've got the center strip here of walnut for the back, and I want to carry that element across the body of the guitar covering that seam. So what I plan to do is I've cut a strip here of walnut, sanded it pretty straight, and what I've done is I found sort of the center line, and I've double stick taped down a couple of just sacrificial strips here that are roughly the correct that surround the actual strip. So they're the width. It creates a channel here that is the width of the inlay here. So at this point, what I'll do is I'll take my X-Acto knife and I'm going to score a line, a couple passes, and create a nice score line. It's better than a pencil mark, and it's a lot more accurate. And once I score those, I'll then pull up these strips of wood, and I'm going to use the Dremel to route out all the material that is between the two lines. Alright, so let's get started here. So you can see there the score lines. I'm not sure if the video can pick that up. Alright, so take this tape off. good. Glued in. Come back in a little while. Alright, so this has been drying overnight. Let's take a look. See how it came out. Good. So I'm just going to use my block plane to take this down to the same level as the body. Thank you.
Basically, I'm going to use my heating blanket to do that, much like I used it to bend the sides. So we are going to wet everything down.
Been about an hour.
Let's take this out. This is gonna be hot. Oh, let's get some gloves on. I think the trick is to only take them out when you're ready to bend. So I'm gonna put these back in. sense. Take one out at a time. Not that malleable. It's bending. Nice and slowly. Nice and slowly.
Alright. So let that dry, and then I'll have to cut up some more strips. Four more should do the other side of the guitar, and then we will glue them onto the body. Alright, so I didn't like the way the bindings came out after I took them out of the mold. They conformed to the shape of the mold, but they were kind of warped. I think I used a little too much water. They were still a little too thick, so they weren't as flexible and pliable as I would want them to be. So I cut some thinner strips and I'm going to heat them up only for 20 minutes at 180 degrees. And then I'm going to bend them right around this guitar rather than doing them in the mold and taking them out afterwards. And we'll see how that goes. One side, so this needs to just cool down to room temperature and stay like this for a while, maybe a couple hours at least. So while that is doing that, I'm going to cut some more strips and do the back.
Well, finally. That took forever. And it's a lot of binding tape. Tomorrow we'll take the tape off and clean everything smooth, sand it. And that's just about all the body will need. Aside from the bridge. Alright, see you tomorrow. Alright, so this has had time to dry overnight, and I'm gonna take off all the tape and see if we can clean this up a bit. China. Thank you. So this is rough sanded with 120 grit. Eventually I'll go 220, then 320. But now, for now, this is basically as far as we're gonna go with the body. I think it looks really nice, and it's now time to start working on the neck, fitting the neck to the body. So that's what we're gonna do next, the next video. And it's come along good, and we are approaching the tail end here. Once we get the neck on, with the fretboard, we can place the bridge, glue that on, fit the tuners, and start thinking about finishing how we're going to do that. So, appreciate everybody watching. Like, comment, and subscribe. We'll see y'all next time.